यस सर, सो
यस सर।
लेट्स बिगिन विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 15। ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, व्हाट वी नीड टू डू इन दिस क्वेश्चन, स्टेट गिविंग रीजंस वेदर द करंट रेशियो विल इंप्रूव और डिक्लाइन और विल हैव नो इफेक्ट In each of the following transaction, if current ratio is 2:1, so children, current ratio means current assets upon current liabilities, and it is given 2:1 means we will write 2:1 in this manner, or we assume one value. We assume that current asset is 20,000, suppose, है ना, we are assuming to simplify the question. Suppose current asset is 20,000 and current liability is 10,000. We are assuming, है ना, this is assumed value. Because 2:1 is given ना. So now we need to give reasons. First, cash paid to trade payable. What will happen? Cash paid to trade payable and ratio is 2:1. Cash paid to trade payable. Children, what will happen if we pay cash to trade payable? Current ratio.
Asset and liabilities will decrease.
Both will decrease, है ना? So, I will explain here. Current asset upon current liability. Current asset we have assumed 20,000. Current liability we have assumed 10,000. Suppose 5,000 rupees trade payable is paid. Assume, we are assuming, है ना? Suppose 5,000 rupees is paid as trade payable. So current asset will be decreased because cash will go out from the business. Yes or no, children? Cash will go out means current asset will decrease. But we are paying trade payable and trade payable is current liability. So current liability will also decrease by 5,000. Yes or no? So both will decrease with similar amount. Let's see what happened. 20 minus 5, 15,000. And 10 minus 5, 5,000. Can you take out the ratio? When we take out the ratio, we get 3 upon 1 or 3:1. Yes or no, dear children? But earlier ratio was 2:1. So what is happening? 3:1 is greater than 2:1. Hence, improve or decline? Improve. It is improve. Yes or no, dear children? You need to write reason also. You can write reason also. Both current asset and current liability are decreasing with same amount. Hence, current ratio will improve. I hope it is clear to everyone on B point. What B point said? Bills payable discharged. Bills payable discharged. Discharge means paid. What will happen? Same thing will happen, isn't it? Huh? Current assets upon current liability, we have assumed that current assets are 20,000 and current liabilities are 15,000. What happened when bills payable are paid? Suppose 5,000 rupees bills payable are discharged. So cash will be reduced by 5,000, current asset, and bills payable is current liability, so it is also reduced by 5,000. How much will left? 15. We have assumed 10, na? 10. 15 divided by 5. It will come 3 upon 1 or 3 is to 1. And 3 is to 1 is greater than 2 is to 1. So what will happen? Hence the ratio is improving. Ratio will improve. And you can write reason. The same reason what we have written in the previous point. Current assets and current liabilities are decreasing with same amount. Hence, ratio or current ratio will improve. I hope it is clear, dear children. Bills receivable endorsed to a creditor What will happen when we endorse bills receivable to a creditor? Let's see. Current asset we have assumed 20,000 and current liability we have assumed 10,000. Suppose bills receivable of rupees 5,000 is endorsed. What is bills receivable, children? Current asset or current liability? Tell me.
Current asset.
So when we endorse bills receivable, so it means it will reduce. Current asset will reduce by 5,000. And what is creditor? Creditor is current liability.
Current liability.
So current liability will also reduce by 5,000. Yes or no? So 20 minus 5, 15,000, and 10 minus 5, 5,000. When we take out ratio, what we get? 3 upon 1 or 3 is to 1. So what is happening? Ratio is improving because 3 is to 1 is greater than 2 is to 1. So we can write reason. The same reason we can write. Hai na? Current asset and current liability both are decreasing with same amount. Hence, current ratio will improve. I hope it is clear to everyone. The point. Let's begin. Payment of final dividend already declared. Okay. Payment of final dividend. Already declared. So we have assumed current asset and current liability 20,000 and 10,000. when we pay dividend, do you think cash will decrease? Yes, cash will decrease. Suppose 5,000 dividend is paid. So cash will decrease by 5,000. Isn't it? And it is declared, so it is the liability of a company to pay. Dividend has to be paid, है ना? So liability will also decrease. So again 15,000 by 5,000, 3 upon 1 or 3 is to 1, and 3 is to 1 is greater than 2 is to 1, hence improve. Again, we can write the same reason. Current asset and current liability both are decreasing. With same amount. Hence, current ratio will improve. I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Purchase of stock in trade on credit. Purchase of stock in trade on credit. What will happen to current asset or current liability? Let's see. Current ratio means current asset upon current liability, and we have assumed current assets 20,000 and current liability is 10,000. When we purchase stock in trade, what happened? Do you think current asset will increase? Will current asset increase by purchase of stock in trade?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So suppose we have purchased of rupees 5,000, we take very simple values to understand. Suppose goods of 50,000 has been, 5,000 has been purchased. So we add 5,000. But children, we have purchased on credit. Do you think liability will increase?
Yes, sir.
Yes, liability will also increase. Now tell me what happened. 20 plus 5. 25,000, 10 plus 5, 15,000, yes or no? So 5, 5 is 25, 5, 3 is 15, 1 by 3 means 33.33, so 1.67 is to 1, yes or no, dear children? Am I correct? And 1.67 is to 1 is less than 2 is to 1. Yes or no, dear children? So what happened? The ratio will decline. So we need to write reason. In examination also we need to write reason, dear children. And in very simply you can write that by purchase of stock in trade on credit, current asset and current liability both are decreasing. Sorry, both are increasing. Both are increasing with same amount. Hence, ratio will decline. That clear, dear students? Bills receivable endorsed to a creditor dishonored बिल्स रिसीवेबल एंडोर्स्ड टू अ क्रेडिटर डिसऑनर्ड Dishonored means not paid, है ना? The person who has to pay is has not paid to the creditor. We have endorsed BR to a creditor, but creditor has not received the money when the time has come. So how it affect current ratio? Let's see. Current ratio means current assets upon current liabilities. We have assumed that 20,000 is current asset and current liability is 10,000. Suppose bills receivable of rupees 5,000 was endorsed. Suppose what happened to current asset? When we endorse, we are endorsed to a creditor dishonor. When it is dishonor, again creditor will increase, है ना? And when creditor will increase, current liability will increase by 5,000. And when BR, bills receivable which was endorsed, if it is dishonored, then your debtors will increase by 5,000. Then your debtors will increase by 5,000 because you have received bill from the person. That bill is dishonored. Now again you need to take money from that person. So what happened? Let's see. 25,000, 15,000. Then we calculate, we get 1.67:1. What does it mean? 1.67:1 is less than 2:1. Hence the ratio will decline. So we can write reason that by bills receivable endorsed to a creditor if dishonored, current assets and current liabilities are increasing. With same amount. Hence the ratio will decline. Hence the current ratio decline. I hope the question is clear to everyone. Ready? Purchase of stock in trade for cash. Purchase of stock in trade for cash. So current ratio is current asset upon current liability. Current asset we have assumed 20,000 and current liability we have assumed 10,000. Suppose we have purchased stock of rupees 5,000 in cash. What happened when we purchase goods for cash? Will it affect current asset?
Yes, sir.
No.
No, sir.
It will not affect. Do you know why it will not affect? Because you have purchased goods, so you will add 5,000 because current asset increases. But dear children, on the other hand, you have paid cash. In cash, it is written, na? For cash. So cash is going out by 5,000. So 5,000 is added because asset is purchased and 5,000 is subtracted because cash has been paid. no change in liability because it is not credit transaction. So you will find there is no change. Yes or no? The ratio will be 2:1. And 2:1 is equal to 2:1. Is that clear, my dear children? So what reason we will write? There is no effect on current asset and current liability. Hence, no change in current ratio. Is that clear, dear children? H. Sale of fixed asset, book value 50 for 45. Sale of fixed asset, book value 50,000 for 45,000. For 45,000. Tell me, what happened to current ratio? Current ratio means current asset upon current liability. Because in this question, value is given, book value 50 and 45. So we can understand in this manner that when we sell fixed asset, what we have received, tell me, 45,000. Yes or no? 45,000 is received. So current liability is not. There is no change, you can write, there is no change in current liability. And current asset, will current asset increase? Yes, we are receiving cash.
Yes,
we are receiving cash, so current asset increases. Simple, so current asset increases and there is no change in current liability. So what will happen? Children, ratio will improve. Obviously, it is very simple to understand. So we can write reason here that current asset is increasing and there is no change in current liability, so current ratio will improve. That clear, dear children? I hope it is clear.
Yes, sir.
So let's see another point. I point. Sale of fixed assets, book value 50 for 60,000. Sale of fixed asset, book value 50 for 60,000, what will happen to current ratio? Current ratio means current asset upon current liability. And when we sell fixed asset, what happened? We receive 60,000 rupees cash. So it means current asset is increasing. Current asset will increase. It is not sold on credit, So that's why there is no change in current liability. No change in current liability. So what will happen? The ratio will improve, obviously. So you can write reason. Current asset increases, current liability no change, so ratio will improve, current ratio will improve. I hope this question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.